Well, I'm styled by Anisha Jain. I'm wearing Rohit Gandhi and Rahul Khanna. And yeah.
Well, here to support IFA today.
Of course.
Any special IFA memory for you to host it as well?
I have a lot of special IFA memories. I have loved hosting the IFA Awards. I have traveled a lot with them. We've had some amazing, stayovers in new places, and it's always been a different audience. And the most amazing thing about IFA is that they allow artists to connect with audiences from all parts of the world, and sometimes it's so overwhelming to see the kind of love that you get in places that you probably thought would probably not even be watching in movies. So I think that is the best thing about IFA. And obviously there is Andre Viraf and Sabas who've been doing this for very long, so I have a personal relationship with them, and so there's a lot of warmth and love for them in my heart.
Quick question on the recent success. Huge numbers.
Yes.
All sorts of responses. Of course, yeah. The getting. So yeah. What's it feeling like right now?
Well, it's amazing, man. I mean, what more can an actor ask for? And the kind of love that the film got. There was so much being said about the film. And I mean, it just goes to show that if a product is made from the right place and it's made with the right intentions, as complex as it might be, the audience seems to get it even sometimes when other, you know, factions of maybe the media or reviewers or a certain section of people don't understand it. But I mean, despite all that, the kind of love that the film got was overwhelming, and I think it's coming of age of Indian cinema. I think we're learning to and becoming braver in the kind of films that we're making. We're not playing safe. We're not trying to do the regular stuff. The protagonist doesn't always have to be a nice guy spreading his arms in the middle of the mountains. He can be complex, he can be dark, and I think that's really coming of age of cinema.